What's cooking, everybody? It's Dor, and in this video I'll be showing you how to fully upgrade your living ship in No Man's Sky. I will be showing you how to get some upgrades as well as making sure they're all S-class, and I will also give you a few setups so you can easily choose which one you want to use and which suits your playstyle best. But without any further ado, let's get straight into it. So first off, to follow this guide, you will of course need a living ship. If you do not have one already, I would suggest to check out this video and then come back to this guide in order to fully upgrade your living ship. Now you may also be wondering why you would want to have a living ship in the first place. Apart from how they look, living ships have fairly decent stats and are focused on damage and hyperdrive range, with a slight debuff to its shields. Living ships use different materials than other starships in order to charge their different technologies. For example, to take off you will need oxygen of Mordite. You can charge your poles with silver or gold. The starship shields are charged with Pugnium. And lastly, if you want to warp into a new system, it will only cost you some chromatic metal. This makes exploring space in a living ship a fairly cheap thing to do. So if you want to find some upgrades for your living ship, all you need to do is just pulse into space. Stop pulsing when the message appears that an anomaly is detected. When it is anything else except for an alien egg, just ignore it and start pulsing right away. After a while it should appear that an alien melody is detected. Exit the pulse and you'll see an alien egg. Shoot it to receive one upgrade module. These can range anywhere from C to S class and are quite consistent within one system. If you have received an upgrade module, I would advise to make a save and reload it in order to be able to receive another one while pulsing. This system though is a bit different, and I'll share the glyphs for you on screen. This system will not give you one but two upgrades in total while pulsing in between save files. The only downside of this system is that there is no space station. So what I would advise you to do is after you've shot the second egg and collected the upgrade module, just warp again, spawn in your freighter, enter it, exit your ship to create an autosave, and then reload the autosave. Once you're back in the game, it's as easy as flying out of your freighter, pulsing until you have the random encounter, pulse again for the first egg, and then pulse again for the second egg. This way you'll have two upgrade modules every time you'll reload, and it's a very easy and quick way to do it. This system was shared on the No Man's Sky Coordinates Exchange subreddit by user Diftree. A huge shout out to him because this system made it very easy to collect all upgrade modules needed to fully upgrade my living ship. So it took me about an hour to receive at least 6 upgrade modules per technology for the living ship. And as I said, the class in which the upgrades drops is very consistent within the system. As you can tell, I have 9 C class pulsing heart nodes, 3 B and 3 A class spewing vent nodes, I have 6 C class neural assembly nodes, 6 B class scream suppressor nodes, 8 C class singularity nodes, and 6 A and 4 S class grafted eye nodes in total. Now of course, if you want to go for a double setup, you'll need 6 upgrade modules per type. Of course, if you go for one of the other setups I will show you, you might not need as many. So the first setup I'll show you is based solely on filling up the organ chambers and having the storage sacks totally clear. This is a perfect setup if you want to use your living ship for exploration and need some empty storage slots within your ship. As we are only using the organ chamber or the technology slots for all upgrades, it's also a perfect setup to be able to fly through black holes or through a center of a galaxy without damaging any of the technology. In order to get the most out of your technology, you want to form squares with the upgrade modules you have. As the storage slots on living ships are non-upgradable, you will have to work with what you got. So place the starship's technology you want to focus your upgrade modules on in such a way that you can place an upgrade module to the right, to the bottom, and to the bottom right corner of it. I will personally be focusing on my launch thruster, my hyperdrive, my pulse engine, and my shields, and not my weaponry. So I place both weapons next to each other so that there's still room for one upgrade per weapon. In this way, if I would fill my entire technology slots up, I would still have one slot left available. You can either place another weapon upgrade module in here, just note that it won't have any adjacency bonus, or of course a figurine or a starship drill if you want that. So now that you have placed all your technology in such a way that you have room around them to place all your upgrade technology modules, it's time to do so. If you already have some S-Class modules, it's good to know that once you install them, their stats are fixed. So every time I will install this S-Class upgrade module, the stat is what it is. So reloading and reinstalling when I've acquired them within one system doesn't have any use. If you want, of course, you can use your S-Class upgrades, or you can use an A-Class upgrade and upgrade it to an S-Class upgrade. Now, an example, if I place a C-Class upgrade module next to the technology, I would want to upgrade it using nanites to an A-Class and not further at this point. So once you have upgraded the upgrade module to A-Class, get out of your ship to create an autosave and then upgrade it to an S-Class to see what stats it will get. So the maximum stats for a pulsing heart upgrade module would be fuel efficiency 20, the maneuverability anywhere between 5 and 12, and for the boost it will be anywhere between 10 and 15. So of course you want to make sure that these upgrades are as close to the maximum as possible. In this case it isn't, so I can just reload the autosave which I just created and try again, and you'll see that the stats will be different. Once you are happy with the stats you've received, just get in and out of your starship to create a new autosave to lock it in place. So now just place all your upgrade module slots around their technology counterpart and upgrade them to A-Class. So place a spewing vent node next to the spewing vent. If you have an A-Class already, of course place that one. If you are lower, then just upgrade it to an A-Class as well. Next you want to place three of your neural assembly nodes next to the neural assembly. Next up, place three scream suppressor nodes next to the scream suppressor. And lastly, place the singularity cortex nodes next to the singularity cortex. So once you've filled up your starship's technology slots, it should look a lot like this. Now of course make sure to create a save before upgrading some of these upgrade modules to S-Class. So I will leave all the maximum stats per upgrade module on screen, but I will also go over them with you. So as mentioned earlier, the pulsing heart will have a max fuel efficiency of 20, the maneuverability will be anywhere between 5 and 12, and the boost will be between 10 and 15. You can go ahead and upgrade all three of the neural assembly upgrade modules as these have fixed stats. An A-Class has a minimum of 15 and a maximum of 20, and S-Class always has a minus 20 reduction to your launch costs, with the added bonus of adding automatic recharging to them, which A-Class doesn't. Same goes for the scream suppressor upgrade modules. These will all feature a 30% increase in your shield strength at S-Class rank. So upgrade them all. The Singularity Cortex upgrades for your hyperdrive will always have 100% warp fuel efficiency. The only difference here on an S-Class module lies within the hyperdrive range, which can vary all the way from 200 to 250 per upgrade module. And finally, the Spewing Vent upgrade module will have a 3% fire rate increase, a 3% heat dispersion, and damage is anywhere between 6 and 8%. So when you're done, your setup should look something like this. The remaining slot can of course be used to add one more remaining weapon upgrade module. Of course this won't have any adjacency bonus, or you can add a figurine or a starship trail, as I did. Now to show you that this setup is perfectly usable to warp to a black hole or a center of the galaxy, I will do so. When you warp to the center of the galaxy, if you do not know yet, you will find yourself within another galaxy. There are 257 galaxies in total in No Man's Sky, so traveling from one another is fun to do, but will damage all technology within your starship's inventory, as well as all technology in your exosuit and in the multi-tool you are carrying at that moment. So once I reach my living ship, you'll see that everything is totally fine and I can just take off and fly off just as you normally would. Now if you want to use your living ship for this or for some general exploring, but do want some extra punch for your weaponry, just make sure to pick whichever weapon you would prefer and move that one to the general inventory slots. This way you can add up to 3 upgrade modules which have a perfect adjacency to your favorite weapon. Of course, don't forget to fill up the empty slots in your organ chamber with some upgrade modules for the grafted eyes. On S-Class, these will have a minimum heat dispersion of 75 to 95%. And an added damage of 24 to 27%. Bear in mind, if you do use this setup, the weapon you've moved to your storage sacks will of course be damaged when you go through a black hole or through the center of the galaxy. Now, if you really want to go all out with your living ship and have the highest damage and hyperdrive range possible, the third setup is something for you. Just note that this will leave barely any space for storage on your living ship. So for this setup, you would want to have your favorite weapon in your technology slots again. This is so you can double up on its damage by also adding 3 upgrade modules in general inventory. So just swap it out with a weapon you don't prefer. While I'm doing so, I want to ask you to please leave a like and or a comment if you found this video helpful in any way, and don't forget to subscribe to be informed on all things No Man's Sky, from beginner's guides to amazing starships and anything in between. Now you just want to add 3 upgrade modules per technology type in your storage sacks. Place them down in a straight line for the best adjacency bonuses. Now of course you do want to upgrade them all to A-class except for the neural assembly and the scream suppressor, as you can both upgrade these to S-class upgrade modules as they don't have min or max stats. For the rest of course make a save before trying to upgrade it to an S-class so you can have the best stats possible from these upgrades. Now I've put all the 3 setups next to each other so you have a clear overview of the stats per setup. So you see about 9 damage potential between the first and the second setup. For some reason, the third setup doesn't show the damage potentials in the stats. It's very weird that it doesn't show in these stats, but you'll see in the live footage that there is indeed a difference between the second and the third setup as well. Furthermore, you can see a clear upgrade in the shield strength between the second and the third setup, as well as the hyperdrive range and of course the maneuverability. As you can see in this footage, the first setup has 522 damage per shot. The second one has 629 damage per shot, and the third one has 726 damage per shot. Again, it's very weird that it didn't show in the stats, but I hope this made it clear for you. And I hope that you can make your choice based on this footage and this video on what setup you would like to use. Please let me know in the comments down below. For myself, I will be using the first setup as I only use my living ship to go through black holes or through the center of the galaxy. I already have a lot of technology to fix on my exosuit whenever I do so, so I really like the benefit of not having to do this as well for my ship. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll hopefully see you in the next one.